In this video, we are going to read about different surveys and maps. Maps means when the survey is conducted. After that, we just store all these things in a systematic way. Clear? First, let us understand the meaning of surveys over there. Here, surveys, it is mentioned that to study or to investigate. That means when we are just going to study or just, you can say, deep knowledge about a particular thing. So all these things is possible only by the surveys, and survey is only possible when we must have any kind of particular topic or a subject on which we just want to acquire different knowledge. Clear? So Britishers in India start surveying about different administration departments, as well as they start surveying about the different they just want to know about the detailed knowledge about the whole country, whether it is about the animals, flora and fauna of our country, about the different soils of our country. All these things they want, that we must have a particular survey in the country. And this survey used to take place after every 10 years. And when this survey took place after 10 years, it is known as our census. Clear? With the help of this, they were able to get an information regarding when they start doing the surveys now. So they start collecting the different information, that what is the population of our country, we are having different caste, so kaun kaun si caste ke log hain, kaun kaun sa religion follow kar rahe hain, kis area mein kaun sa occupation popular hai hamare paas. So in this way they start surveying about the different things and then recorded them in a systematic way. And after that, when these surveys were took place, so they start surveying about the different contents like population survey. उन्होंने क्या करा, अलग अलग criterias बना लिए survey करने के, population survey, botanical survey, zoological survey. So in this way they start making the different surveys so that they can able to know about the whole system of our country India. But when all these official documents were recorded, so somehow it has its demerits also. Demerits means negative impacts, or you can say that some limitations, कि कुछ कमियाँ ऐसी रही जो हमारे पास archaeological survey पूरा नहीं कर पाया. Let us have a look. Although basically official records were important and they provide us very detailed information regarding the British rules over there. Clear? But the information regarded our common people, we didn't get any information regarding our common people, about the interest of the common people, what were the situations of our common people when Britishers arrived in our India. So this is the main drawback of our official records, or the shortcomings means kami rahi hamare in official records ki they didn't able to express about the interest about the common people over there. Clear? This is the shortcoming of official records. Apart from the official records, we are having other records also, other sources also, like literatures, from the different literatures, biographies means jab kisi ke bare mein proper detail likha jata hai, autobiographies, some people used to write down the books for themselves only, as I think in 9th class as in 8th class you study about all these things. मैनी प्लेज, मैनी स्टोरीज, जब हम लोग भी अपने कई बार हिंदी में चैप्टर्स होते हैं, कई बार कहीं पे इंग्लिश में चैप्टर्स होते हैं, कुछ डिफरेंट स्टोरीज हमारे पास आती हैं इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ नरेशंस एंड ऑल दीज थिंग्स. सो इन दिस वे वी जस्ट कम टू नो अबाउट द डिफरेंट सिचुएशंस ऑफ आर ब्रिटिश ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी, एज वेल एज अबाउट द ट्राइबल पीपल्स, अबाउट द पीजेंट्स, अबाउट द डिफरेंट सिचुएशंस ऑफ अ डिफरेंट पीपल of our country during that colonial period. Clear? So this is all about our archaeological sources. In my next video, I'll tell you about the literary sources over there. So in this literary sources, in my next video, I'll try to complete the chapter over there. Till then, read about the archaeological sources. Take and just go through with the whole topic in a very systematic and with full concentration. Till then, take care. Bye bye.